Warm greetings and welcome to the Spring of Grace. Today we are in the third commandment. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Many of us understand this commandment rightfully as warning us against using swear words, curse words, or profanity while using the name of the Lord. As I grew up, we considered very godless those people who use the name of the Lord in vain by using words like, I swear, truth of God, and such. We considered them the future fuel for the fires of hell. The rest of us considered ourselves proud keepers of the third commandment. And while it is true that this commandment warns against using the name of God lightly or in a blasphemous way, it is much, much deeper than that. It's much broader. In what we call the Lord's Prayer, Jesus showed us how to use the name of the Lord. And the very first line says, "Our Father who is in heaven, hallowed or holy is your name." So we must treat God's name as holy, use it as holy in our speech, in our coda. We must honor the Lord as holy. This commandment reminds us not to dishonor the Lord in any way, not to abuse it in a word, in coda, not by cursing, not by profanity, not by mocking or irreverent use of the word of the name of God, but also in our coda. Think of this verse, Matthew chapter 7, verse 21. "Not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord will enter the kingdom of heaven. Only those who actually do the will of my Father will enter." This is Jesus speaking. Is that not using the name of the Lord in vain when you call him Lord, Lord, and then you do not do what he says? Listen again to 2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 19. It says, "But God's foundation stands firm, and it bears this seal: the Lord knows those who are his, and let everyone who names the name of the Lord depart from wickedness." Everyone who names the name of the Lord, that word name also is the word confess. Let everyone who confesses with his mouth the name of the Lord, who calls him Lord, Lord, depart from iniquity. Let him do the will of the Father. That is what it means not to take the name of the Lord in vain. So if you call him Lord, so if you claim to have a testimony, so if you confess his name, but you have not departed from iniquity, that is indeed using the name of the Lord in vain. But I must also add that to use the name of the Lord in vain also applies to those of us who preach and also those of us who claim to hear from the Lord. Jeremiah chapter 23, verse 30 to 32 says, "I am against the prophets, declares the Lord, who steal my words from one another. Behold, I'm against the prophets who declares the Lord, who wag their tongues and declare the Lord has spoken. Behold, I'm against those who prophesy lying dreams. They declare and they lead my people astray, using lies and reckless words. Yet I did not set them or charge them." And so to use the name of the Lord must also be that I have heard him, the word of the Lord. To declare that you are talking in the name of the Lord and you are not talking on his behalf, then it's to use the name of the Lord in vain. So I will be very careful if I'm listening to a person who says the Lord has spoken. Is it a person who is taking the name of the Lord in vain, or is it a person who has really heard the Lord? So I want to conclude by reminding you this concerning this third commandment. God's foundation remains sure, and it is sealed with this inscription: everyone who names the name of the Lord must depart from iniquity, from wickedness. Shalom, and the Lord bless you as you live a holy life to honor the name of the Lord. Amen.